Group A has 7 kids and the median age is 13. So that's group A. Group B has 9 kids. So 9 kids and the median is 9. And now these 4 are being exchanged. So they are being swapped. So something like this. And they're asking what is the new median of group B. So with this groundwork, let's look at statement 1. Statement 1 says that the oldest child in B was 12 years old. So this says this guy is 12 years old. He goes here and this guy comes in here. So he is definitely going to be more than 13 years old. So the new guy who comes in here would be more than 13 years old. So definitely this guy, let's say his name is he's X. So the new guy here will be X. But the real problem is the age of this person. If this kid happens to be more than 9 years old, then he would settle somewhere here, okay? And then the median would shift. So the age of this person is very important. Without this person, it is difficult to say whether 9 will remain the median or whether it will change. So statement 1 is not sufficient. Look at statement 2. Statement 2 tells that this guy is 8 years old. See, if he is 8 years old, he comes in here. So he will either come here or he will remain somewhere here. When put in increasing order, 8 would lie either in one of these 4 places. Definitely it would be less than 9. Okay, so here nothing will change. And we know that 13 is the median here while the oldest person here is 12 years old. So the oldest guy here is definitely going to be more than 13 years old. Without using statement 1, I can say that this guy is going to be more than 13 years old. So whoever he is, however old he is definitely going to be the oldest guy here. So the oldest guy remains here. The youngest guy would occupy one of these 4 positions. And therefore, the position number 5 will remain intact. So using statement 2 alone, we can say that the median will not change. It will remain 9. And therefore, statement 2 is sufficient. B is the right answer.